that you're only playing. Don't take it too seriously. Because if you take it too seriously, you're going to start destroying each other and fighting and...
Just the internet's just gone crazy about this, so...
Guitar with a little mini guitar.
It's her daughter, and Kristen was so excited to be able to bring her daughter with her. And we hadn't seen her on the course yesterday, but she's on the course today, so maybe that's what Kristen needs to calm herself, center herself.
Happened to be Paige's cat. I know Haley.
The stakes at this first major of the year.
Member of the team is chosen for his or her own completely unique set of abilities.
To Joe Chargaloff.
Joe, the PDGA president.
To Joe Chargaloff.
I'm no stranger to the rain, but there'll always be tomorrow, and I'll beg, steal, or borrow a little sunshine.
Well, I have a friend who was on the player group, happened to be caddying for another player. And this is, a trusted friend of mine, Haley Childs, lovely woman, very good head on her shoulders.
And that's Haley Childs on the bag.
And you're saying she's a local to the course?
Yeah, Haley's a local, a wonderful player in her own
right.
Yeah,
I wonder why she's not, I guess she maybe didn't qualify for the event?
Well, she's taken the last few years off. She's gone to school to become, I believe, a dental assistant.
Yeah, right on. Do we have a paper? One of the premier caddies to have on the course, right?
Indeed. And Haley, man, she grips the disc and she rips it. She's got just a natural, tough, aggressive shot and just such a lovely person, too. So what a great choice for a caddy. Knows the course, really calming influence, keeps it nice and light.
She's not even caddying. She's just hanging out there. Like, she had the caddy badge on, but she's just there for support to watch her mom play. In the United States, like, this is her first trip over to watch her mom play. We want her daughter here. We want her daughter to know that disc golf is inclusive, like, no matter what age you are. I don't know how it even got brought up to Elaine or...
How did that even hit you, so to speak?
Well, it was after the players finished holing out on hole number two. The cameras had a nice close-up of Kristen and her daughter actually was... trying to pick up Kristen's bag, and then Kristen took it from her. Mm. And so when I saw that, a whole bunch of things went through my mind. The first one is,
I'll get you, my pretty, and your little kid.
Did Kristen take that bag from her daughter because she knows her daughter's too young to caddy? Or, was it just too heavy for her? And then it just kind of occurred to me, well, I wonder if she's even aware of the rule, because rule 113A that said if there are children under 13, they need to be supervised by a separate adult.
Oh, that's a boomer.
You'll need to use all your tricks.
Need to use all your tricks. You'll need to use all your tricks.
My intention was to just, in case Kristen was unaware, I just wanted to get some information to her so that she can be empowered.
Joe, the PDGA president, comes in between us and he's like, hey, Haley, Elaine King sent you a text message. Do you mind checking your phone? And I just thought that was weird already. Why is he talking to us? And why is Elaine, first of all, Elaine's doing commentary. He said that he was unaware of what the message was, but he got a text also from Elaine. But Elaine said some variation of like, tell Kristen her daughter needs to be supervised and behind the ropes with someone who isn't a player or a caddy. I don't want my caddies to talk to me unless I want to talk to them. And so I definitely don't know what my competitors want as far as being talked to, being, hey, even like good shot.
I understand it's kind of weird that the only person I could get in touch with was, just happened to be Paige's cat. I understand it's kind of weird
because it's just weird.
I understand it's kind of weird.
It's really, really, really weird.
It is a weird, it's a weird, weird situation. And I think that's a weird, that could cause weird conflict of interest situations. A commentator ever texting a player or a caddy during an event to alert them of something.
Or she could be disqualified. Then I'm like, what's happening? What is going on? And she just told me, like,
trusted friend of mine, Haley Childs. So I sent her a message because she's a local player and she knows a lot of people there. If Kristen needed any help in coming into compliance, like, I knew Haley could take care of her. Indeed, Haley in due course got the message and was able to just quietly pull on some resources, as I understand it. That's where Haley was invaluable because, you know, she knew some people in the crowd and was able to help identify, you know, a suitable person to act as a, you know, to watch over Isabel.
For your mom to have to be like, hey, everything's gonna be okay, but I need you to go with this stranger. You're gonna be able to watch me, but you're just gonna be a little bit farther back from me.
And, you know, everything just seemed to be absolutely fine. Seemed to be absolutely fine. Kristen continued to play on. I think she deuced the next hole and she's, you know, hit the gauntlet of number five and almost deuced it. And you know, everything just seemed to be absolutely fine. So.
Because this was obviously something that affected Kristen because it's her daughter and it was a weird situation and her daughter's in a foreign country. It obviously could have been something that got into Kristen's head.
Clearly you affected Kristen's mindset for some period of time.
And, you know, everything just seemed to be absolutely fine.
Clearly you affected, in what capacity we'll never know. Clearly you affected Kristen's mindset for some period of time.
She's really sad right now.
Paige Pierce.
We'll never do Elaine. That again. Never, ever.
Five
I've learned
time
my
downing
lesson.
Another five time. Oh, come gosh. On. Oh, my goodness.
Elaine, what the hell is happening here?
Paige came in seventh at 9 under, and Kristen won the tournament at 24 under. So not even close.
It's a beatdown.
Not even close.